We talk exclusively with the guys from Florida Georgia Line in an artist spotlight. Music City 411 starts now. What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Music City 411. I'm your host, Shane Tallant, here in Nashville, Tennessee, and we've got a very special episode this week, an artist spotlight with the boys from Florida Georgia Line.
Baby, you a song, you made me want to roll my windows down and cruise.
Good to see you guys.
How are you? What's going on?
I'm good, and the question is, how are you guys? You had one heck of a year. Let's start, before we get to the obvious, their debut number one, let's start, where, how'd you guys meet? How'd you guys end up being together?
Well, we both went to Belmont University and met there our senior year and just kind of started hanging out and kicking it and writing songs. And man, one thing kind of led to the next. We graduated college, ended up moving in, me and him and a couple buddies in the same house, and just kept working hard and trying to pay rent and write songs and get out and play shows, man. And one thing kind of led to the next. Here we are.
In Nashville, writing songs, I mean, you can swing a cat and hit a songwriter. They're everywhere, but very few get to say that they got a song recorded, number one, get a record deal, number two, and then have a number one. And you guys were able to do it with your debut number one single. So the first time you were ever heard on the radio, that song went to number one. What does that mean to you?
Man, it's been like a dream year. I mean, we've said it a million times, and it's been fun to be a part of something so special. You know, number one songs are rare, and especially, you know, your debut single. So we're living it up and loving it. And it's cool to be able to share, you know, this success with our friends and co-writers and everything. It's been awesome.
Mentioning the co-writers, when you sit in the room and you write the song, a lot of times people say you must have known it was a hit from the minute you finished the last lyric. Is that the case here? When did you guys realize that you had something good?
Well, you never want to jinx it and say you got a hit. I think, we knew it was a good song. We knew it was a special one. And, the more we produced it with Joey in the studio and just really, you know, saw it came to life, we knew we're definitely honored and blessed to be a part of what's going on and to see Cruz just climb the charts the way it did and sell as many as it sold is crazy.
I'm glad you mentioned the title, because for those that we didn't yet, it's called Cruz, and it's one of the catchiest songs I've heard in a long time. What's the quick backstory behind it? What was the inspiration for it?
We were in the middle of another song, actually, and the first line of the chorus kind of got thrown out, and just ran with it and lived, sat with it for a couple days, took it back in the studio and tweaked it up, rewrote it, and Joey just made an amazing track. And man, it's like Tyler said, it's one of those special songs. You know, we knew we had something cool and something that was different, and I don't think we ever imagined, you know, it'd take kind of a life of its own. So,
where were you guys when you got the call that it went number one?
I think it was an email, I believe, and I think we were on the road somewhere. I don't even know, but we were heading. I remember because we celebrated that night on the way back and popped a couple of champagne bottles. But yeah, man, we were pretty jacked up about that.
Well, that's pretty exciting. Congratulations on a debut number one single, Florida Georgia Line with Cruz. And we're not done with them. When we come back next week, we're going to talk about where we are, what they're up to, and their ACM nomination as well. So until next time, thanks so much for watching Music City 411. Make sure you follow us on Twitter and check out our Facebook page as well. And thanks for loving country music. We'll see you next week.